seems like years since it's been here. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun, and I say it's all right.
But let's start with a little history. In our younger years, when there were time constraints, we did the houseboat thing with friends a few times. The river was quieter then. As we neared retirement, we completed some longer sections of the river in our 18-foot cedar strip Canadian canoe. Our longest single trip was the 200 kilometers from Wentworth to Border Cliffs. We paddled, with help from the flow, at 25 kilometers a day. Again, time constraints limited the expedition.
Here comes the sun, and I say, it's all right.
Then we retired and found our perfect boat. It may look a bit different, but later I'll explain what we like about it. We have almost completed the Murray from Yarrawonga to Wellington, just need to go back and complete the Barham Forest through the Narrows. Low water made this a bit too interesting with the snags in the river.
Sun, 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 here it comes. Little darling.
Most of the river is easy to navigate, but there are sections where it's a good idea to watch the river carefully. The submerged river red gums can have some nasty branches just below the surface. Of course, this varies with river levels. The following Google Earth images are extracted from the Yarrawonga to Barmer passage and show it at a really low river level. Many of the snags in the river are visible above the surface. Those below the surface will produce a wake, giving you warning of their presence. There are sections of the river where you must keep a good lookout and keep your speed down. Our GPS system is set to warn us if we exceed our speed in these areas. But you will bump occasionally.
It feels like years since it's been here. Here comes the sun.
Fling on the river, it's very tempting to look for nice sandbars to camp on for the night. Our experience has been that there is very little water depth around sandbars. We have also discovered that sandbars, with nearby reeds, tend to be a haven for myriad insects that swarm at night. Our preference is to nudge into a vertical bank in deep water. These are normally clay with little foliage and minimal insects. They also offer the best chance of some respectable firewood.
Little darling, it seems like years since it's been here. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun, and I say.
If you're looking at traveling the Murray from Yarrawonga to the border, it's a good idea to go online and buy a copy of the River Murray Charts book. It's an invaluable resource for your journey. Whilst traveling, we reference the charts in the book with the app Maps.me for phone and tablet. It's a free app. The maps can be downloaded, so you don't need a signal for it to work. It also relates you the nearest roads in case of an emergency. If you can afford the time, go slowly, explore the towns, meet the people. There are so many museums, historic locations, markets and parks to visit on your adventure. As you would have heard many times, it's not about the destination, it's about the journey.
I feel the ice is slowly melting.
Everyone has different views on how to travel on the Murray. Without question, our favorite is by canoe. You slip along silently close to the bank, proffering the very best opportunity to see myriad birds and animals that generally aren't particularly disturbed by your presence.
Take me back to my boat on the river. I need to go down.
In the Murray River Charts book, you will see the depth of the water at points where it is important that you have this information for safe navigation. In the top right-hand corner of the page of the chart you are referring to, you will see the river level in relation to the depth shown on the chart. If you access the Daily River Murray Levels website, you can find the river level for the day. It's then quite simple to add or subtract the chart level from today's level to calculate current clearance.
Pass my boat on the river, so I don't cry out anymore.
Our preference when tying up is nose in on a vertical bank. With nose in, your propeller is in the deepest water. This is essential if you are mooring on a sandbar. As illustrated, ropes are tied from either quarter and the bow. We normally tie to trees, but we have some large tent pegs, just as an in case.
Down on my face disappears. Take me down to my boat on the river, and I won't cry out anymore.
Three long blasts on your hooter will alert the lock keeper of your arrival. If canoeing, the phone number of the lock is in the charts book. Proceed slowly into the lock when the lights turn green. With a tailwind, be prepared to reverse and pull you stern into the wall of the lock. Even if you muck up. Remember, the lock keepers have seen much worse with inexperienced skippers in giant houseboats.
Everyone has different ideas about their boat. Here are some features of our boat that we like. Firstly, it's light and easy to tow and launch and draws just 30 centimeters. It's an age thing, so climbing a couple of steps onto the foredeck, rails and a gangplank make boarding easy. The sack truck is for replenishing fuel, water and supplies. A good galley essential for us, and when we remove the helm seats, a full-length 4-inch foam folding mattresses ensures good sleep.
And I won't